Ryanair 244, taxi, holding point, Romeo 1, Romeo 22, Firelink, Arrival, Hotel, and Romeo 1.
Taxi, holding point, Romeo 1, Romeo 22,
Firelink,
Arrival, Hotel, and Romeo 1.
Hopefully that's live and you can hear me okay. Let's see if that's that's working okay. Should do a quick radio check with Stansted. Stansted, just jumped over somewhere. Blocked someone.
NH 1016 information Romeo. Requesting VFR touch and goes at Stansted.
In fact, let's get the ATIS first. Let's check the ATIS.
Station call and standby break Ryanair 244 from Romeo 1, Romeo 22. Cliff takeoff, service wind 200 degrees 6.
We just tune the ATIS in the standby.
Transition level, flight level 70, surface wind 200 degrees 6 knots, visibility 10 kilometers or more, no cloud detected, temperature plus 26, G point plus 15. QNH 1016. Acknowledge receipt of information Romeo.
16 information Romeo.
Advise aircraft type on first contact.
Cool.
That'll be fine now. Short selection.
Short selection, Roger. Call me when ready for push and start.
Local. Short selection.
Tell good evening, Ryanair 32 Charlie Victor requesting radio check, please.
Ryanair 32 Charlie Victor, stand to tower readability 5.
Thank you, and Ryanair 32 Charlie Victor on stand 43, information room on board, type A320, looking for the clearance to Dublin as far, please.
Ryanair 32 Charlie Victor, clear to Dublin, Utah for 1 Romeo departure, squawk 0472.
Roger, clear Dublin, Utah for 1 Romeo, and squawk 0472 for Ryanair 32 Charlie Victor.
Ryanair 32 Charlie Victor, correct, QNH 1016.
0472. Alright, so let's get these packs boarding and loaded then, shall we? So they're on underway. I'm gonna drop this tab off a little bit.
Ryanair 244, no further ATC available. Monitor Unicom 122 decimal 8, connect.
Over to Unicom, Ryanair 244, connect.
Ryanair. We'll put the evening music on, shall we? The Ryanair evening boarding. As if there's like different music for their boarding phases. I mean, that's pretty cool, actually.
Panzer 2531 Stansted Tower, good afternoon. I have not received a flight plan from you, can you please refile?
Hasn't received a flight plan. Cool, so that's all loading in. We check the brief. So he's already cleared us on the Utah, hasn't he? So what we can do is we can... Don't know what I'm doing here. Whoa, that's Atsu AOC flight initiate. Data request.
253 on somewhere.
That's gone in okay. Yeah, so we can request the route.
The fans are 2531 Stansted to Ivy, clear the spinning reach copy.
We'll grab the wind as well while we're here.
The fans are 2531 Bid 2 Bremen, Clacton to Echo departure to walk 2070.
Cool, we'll insert that. Awesome. So it's given us the Tarva departure, so it's going to be off 2-2, I think. So Tarva 1 and reduce that one. Awesome. Awesome. So with flight number, we're going to be Ryanair 3-2 Charlie Victor. The really unrealistic cost index of 30, but who cares? And we're going to go up to flight level.
Shots of X-ray.
Go on, flight plan, tell me. 300. That's quite high for this route, isn't it? Maybe it's not. So let's just get the charts up on Navigraph. Right, initial climb 4,000 then. Set that, that's checked. We are fueling, so... Are we fueling? What do we need? We need 5.3, okay, that'll do. So we can see what's going to come on. Let's cool the cabin down a little bit. Quite muggy tonight, so keep them cool. The VAC can go to captain. Everything's looking pretty good.
Our session starts to tell us closing in 10 minutes.
So it's closing in 10 minutes, so if we can get out before that, then at least we'll get some ITC. Awesome. Let's see what's about, shall we? Okay, so we've got a BA, Ryanair next to us, Lufty. Awesome. Look at that. Should be a lovely sunset departure, actually, if we get a move on. Oh, stop faffing around. Let's get a move on. Reedy, right. What's the timer on? Ah, okay. We can actually... Oh, we're ready to go if our packs have hurried up on board.
Ryanair 92 reach Kilo Sunset Tower, cleared to Salzburg, Clacton to Echo departure, squawk 6672.
Right, we're all loaded. Awesome. Right, let's get some pumps on for the fuel. An APU's coming on. So what I'm going to do now is, what am I going to do? I am going to... We haven't got a jetway, have we? No, we haven't got a jetway. I'm thinking I've got a jetway and I'm in the PMDU, that's why. Doors can close, stairs can go. APU, how's it looking? Coming up. Right, let's get our pushback ready to go, actually. Manual, oh, what have I done? Oh, what did I press that for? Stop pushback.
Ground, please cancel pushback operation. Roger, pushback cancelled.
Pre-planned pushback. So they'll probably push us on the first taxiway here, so we'll just go for something like that. That'll do. Request pushback. Right, stop that. I'm going to get the safety announcement going. GPU can go. And run a 3-2 Charlie Victor, stand 4-3. Request push and stop, please.
Run a 3-2 Charlie Victor, stand 4-3. Push and start, please.
Push approved. Run a 3-2 Charlie Victor. Awesome. So we are push and start approved. We've disconnected everything, I think.
Also, next to request.
Shelter X-ray, taxi, heading from Sierra, runway 22.
Awesome, that's done.
Sierra.
We are cleared for start and push.
I need to check, it's 1016, isn't it? 1016.
Got the holding point,
but by 1016 will have the beacon can come on, and then we will release the parking brake. Off we go.
Yeah, we'll start in the sequence.
Turn the cabin lights off. Company message, we probably have the up to date weights on that one, I reckon. Let's just double check the latest load sheet. 50. Let's get the engine started while we're doing that. What are you telling me? What's wrong? Thrust wasn't in neutral. So if you're like 59.3 and 29.7. What? Where's that going? 297, okay, that's that. Fuel on board 4.4. Okay, that's done it. Perfect. Perfect. Let's do our departure checks. Oh, green screen. Yes, mate. Gotta love it in you. Told you earlier. Yeah, gotta love it. Oh, 04, plan for 04, run noob. 2.2. Sync.
Okay, push back and
good start, engine 2, start engine 1. Parking brake is set. Like it's all going today. 145, 145, 147. I'm not doing flaps 3 again today. That was your fault earlier. Flaps 1 down 0.3. I blame you for that. 100% blaming you for that, you know. It's funny though. Yeah, I could reverse it, but yeah, I could actually, couldn't I? But the only reason I've done it like that was because I wanted to be on the left side of the screen, if that makes sense. I will do it, but just bear with. Let me try and. However, we have now shut the door. So if you look on the image, you'll see the cabin doors open. And now, if you look again. I mean, how cool is that? You got to admit, that is pretty damn good. Now, that's the only problem. I'm looking the other way now. So I need to now transform myself to be that way. Yeah, that'll do. Oh, dear, what a faff this is. That's better. There we go. That is cool. There you go. That is cool. So now the cabin door is shut. I think I need to move myself over a little bit. Now I've done that, don't I? Yeah. Yeah, it's going to take some getting used to. I've literally spent like 10 minutes trying to set it all up. So, yeah. It'll work anyway.
Northeast, do not block Bravo.
Do not block Bravo. Oh, okay. Right, I'm like a bit behind with this percent. Run a 3-2 Charlie Victor request taxi. So let's get the flap down.
Runway 22, Charlie Victor, taxi, 100.0, runway 22, via Link Charlie, Hotel Sierra.
Baltimore Sierra 122, Link Charlie, Hotel Sierra, runway 32, Charlie Victor. So where's that then? Let's have a look. Charlie, so straight in front basically then. All the lights are on, APU can go off, flaps one set. I'm going to do everything before we actually head off because it's such a short taxi.
When you established
load check, except 59.3, that's checked.
Roger that, 747
X-ray. 0472 squawking. Let's go.
The fans are 2531, taxi.
I'm the boss, mate. I'm the boss in this house.
Bravo, hotel.
That's what I tell myself, anyway. No, it's fine. I've got like a little office at the back of the house, so it didn't really affect anyone, to be honest. And I'll fold it away when it's not in use either, anyway, so it didn't really matter, to be fair. I feel like I've not done something again, as usual. I always do this. Grounds was on company message. Why is that not gone? There it is. Is that because I haven't pressed accept on it? Yeah, there you go. Awesome. She didn't watch the stream. It's probably boring as hell for her, mate, to be honest. I don't know, she might prove me wrong, but yeah, I don't think she does. I'm running a 3-2 Charlie Victor, will be fully ready on reaching. Just because I want to get back to clearance.
Thanks from Sierra 1, runway 22 Cliff Takeoff, 0220 degrees, 6 knots.
From 22 Cliff Takeoff, running a 3-2 Charlie Victor, thank you. Okay, auto brake is max. Takeoff config is checked and normal. This shows something I haven't done, but I hope. Who cares? Beacons are all on, lights are all on. We need to go TARA. Did we ding the cabin? That's probably what I forgot. Ding the cabin. Boom. Done. Bar shot. Ground we're on. Manflex 68 SRS runway to first blue. We're rolling. Go. Gear up.
Oh,
Tunicom, thanks for service on A32 Charlie Victor, bye bye. Okay, first climb is checked.
Taxi 1 to 8,
we have set. Laps can come up. Yeah, you're right, mate. It is the perfect time of the day, isn't it? It's absolutely... Oh, wow, look at that. Wowzers. I wanted to try and get a view of... of how nice the sunset is. Yeah, it's nice, that is. Such a nice turn, isn't it, after departure from 2-2 here on the Utah back. It sort of brings you around to the right and then up towards, okay, on the map actually. So you turn right and then you turn left. It's a bit of a faff really, but it's to keep you out of Luton's airspace, isn't it? So let's just de-arm the spoilers. We'll do the climb announcement. Nah, you went on a date? Oh, no way. What, that one there? Where's that then? I don't even attempt to know where that is. Fair play. How did the day go? Or is that one not to talk about? Right, let's straight up to 300, isn't it? Yeah. Open climb flight over 300. Nice Italian restaurant. Ah, fair play. Fair play. So is there going to be a second date or...? Oh, there's another aircraft over there. Yeah, just about to see his lights. Probably going into Stansted. I'm just going to quickly look on VATscope actually, see what's about. I thought London was on, to be honest. A bit as I was coming on, but I've obviously just logged off, haven't I? Cool, there's nothing really to affect at the moment, so that's quite cool. I don't mind that sometimes, having no ATC and things like that. Doesn't really bother me sometimes. Sometimes I'm a bit like, give or take ATC, like. Okay, let's just set that to standard. Once, twice, three times a lady. Possibly, okay. Okay, that's better than I know. It's better than a no. Keep working at it. Do like Italian food though, I must say. It's real nice. You obviously had pizza. See if else can come off. Absolutely. Nice big pizza. You can't beat it, can you? I mean, how could you go to an Italian restaurant and not a pizza? I mean, come on. It should be illegal not to. American style pizza. Go on then. Tell me what's the difference, American style and Italian style pizza. I think the Italian style style's just thinner crusts, isn't they? Is that right? I do prefer thinner crusts, to be fair. Yeah, that's right. I thought so. See, I don't know. I think I quite like the... you like the deep pan. Yeah. They're alright. I quite like the pizza up ones, to be fair. That looks like another loader out, don't they? Ah, now that will be EasyJet, won't it? Going into Luton. Can you see that there? He's going into Luton, isn't he? Yeah, I like Papa John's pizza as well. Oh, yeah. They're nice ones, aren't they? Yeah, that's an easy bus, that is. And then Luton's just behind that cloud there. Oh, the pizza buffet. Oh, you're telling me. They're all right until it's busy, and then there's no blooming pizzas out, like it's, you know. But yeah, if you go at a quiet time, they're amazing. You are the face of Papa John's then. You can't beat a good Papa John's, I must say. Yeah, I don't know why I'm just looking at the stream now, but I'm radiating light off my head. I think I've got some of the colour settings not perfect, so that's quite funny. But yeah, I'm no technical whiz, so I'll give myself a bit of leeway on that one, I think. I wonder if turning the light off will help, actually. Let me check. Turn the light off. One of the lights. It's helped a little bit, actually. Yeah, that's helped a little bit. I need to just sit down and fix all the settings and make sure it all works okay. The one dial I can't seem to find is this the autopilot section there. I don't know how to actually turn the brightness up on the actual. I'm sure there's a light somewhere which you can. Ah, is this it here? PFD, ND. See, that actually just changes the actual. Another console floor. Yeah, I found it before and I can't remember for the life of me where it is. Is it in a weird place up on the up above? No. I don't know where that is then. Sure, I'll find it when I'm looking for it. Floodlights. So the lights seem to be up like the brightest they can be, so. Okay, it's fine. Not bothered. Right. Let's have a quick gander at what we might be using in Dubbers. I'm going to guess 2-8 left, maybe. Let's have a look. Yep, 2-8 left. It's a pretty safe bet, really, 2-8 left, isn't it? 2-8 left, so it's going to be, if we're going in by bags, oh, is it going to be 1 X-ray? 3 X-ray? Okay. Oh, they must have changed them for the new runways. I bet they've changed all the arrivals for that. So I'm going to go with... Do we think the X-ray? Let's have a look. Bags-o. 2-8 left, 3 X-ray. Okay, so they've got 3 X-ray there, which is... okay, so that's just a left-hand, then a right-hand turn. So we'll just mark that one. And that one's more of a... Okay, we'll go for the... Which one's this one? 3 Lima. I think we'll go for the X-ray, you know. Yeah, I should go for the X-ray. Let's do it. Let's go for the X-ray. So, ERDW, 2-8 left. Bags are free X-ray. Fire. These have changed, you know. Pizza. Talking about, see, there you go. Talking about pizza. Talking about Papa John's. Pizza. Is there any waypoint at Dublin? That's pretty cool. I like that. They must have changed some of the procedures around them for the new runway, I would imagine. Let's just see how that looks quickly on the plan page. That's not too bad, actually. You kind of just loop round to the left and then obviously back to... At least they haven't messed with Lapmo. Lapmo's my favourite waypoint ever. When you get directs to Lapmo, it's so good. 2-8 left, isn't it? Yeah. 2-8 left, so we've got 5 miles. ADW 2-8 left. And then we'll put a 10 mile ring in as well. Awesome. We'll grab the latest weather. ADW METAR, yes. Send. Receive messages. Weather data. There we go. Right. 1016. Help if I get on the right page, wouldn't it? 1016. Temperature, we've got 18 degrees. 230 at 4 knots. 143 for the VAP. Definitely not config 3. Definitely config 4. After earlier's debacle. And let's have a look at the minimums. 2-8 left is going to be 402. Fantastic. That's all sorted then. Yeah, look at that. Wow. I mean, look at the actual fuselage. You can actually see scratches on the paintwork and stuff like that. I just think that's so cool. How well textured, the detail, the textures are. Absolutely mint that is. Do I dare messing with these colours on this webcam while I'm always streaming? makes it even brighter. Contrast. That's not too bad now, I don't think. Does that help with the shininess? That's alright. That'll do. I'll do it properly another time. Get it set properly. Oh, we're at flight level 300. That was quick. Let's get Jamie's tray table out. Nice. Time to chill. I do think this background though on that seat is pretty damn cool. I need to try and get like round edges and stuff on it just to make it look a bit better, but and then once I've got all the webcam colours all sorted, that's going to look brill. Simple things please me. Oh, the ATC's gone off at Dublin. That's a shame. Never mind. Just done. Oh, well, let me back through the cabin now. You bugger. Oh, that should be okay, actually, because I didn't save it, did I? That was such an anti-climax. Okay, it's not letting me go any further that way now. Okay. There we go, there's the beacon view. In our tube. Let me in. Let me in. So empty. Oh wow, it's even got the Lauder logo on the carpet. How cool is that? That's pretty impressive, that is. I'm not going to be far from top of this. There it is, okay, Penil. So it's about 10-15 minutes away, that is. I can hear someone on. Someone keep transmitting on Unicom. cool. We're into the sun now. So cool, that is. Okay, so we said 2-8 left. Bags are free to try, and there's no ATC on, so who cares? Oh, see, that's done that again, hasn't it? The Sim Toolkit Pro has done that again. It's not connected properly. Disconnect, connect, see if this works. Yeah, it's not showing the right information. I wonder if I reconnect. Let's try that. Close that there. Try again. Restore flight. See if that works, and then connect to sim, connect to Microsoft Flight Sim. Ah, there we go. Climb. Doubt it, mate. I'm actually needing descent. So cabin door, cockpit door even, open, cockpit door closed. Oh dear, I'm into time boys, so silly things. Okay, so we're going to be going down from Bagso, flight level 100 or below Bagso, so that should be in there. Let's just double check. Flight level 100 or below, perfect. Awesome. You don't really have to do much, do you, as an Airbus pilot, to be fair? I mean, I've not really done anything, have I? Just pressed the button after he took off, and then, well, that was it. Those clouds though, wow, look at those. That is stun war. So we just over to the left of us is Runcorn, so Liverpool area. Oh, there is actually Liverpool Airport. Just on the banks of the Mersey. Oh, there's our top of descent. What did we say? Q&H was in Dublin. I think it was 1016, wasn't it? Same as it was in Stansted. So I'm going to put that on the standby because I just can't be bothered to forget when we're on approach what it is. So yeah, I can't remember how to turn this up. The autopilot panel. I can't remember how to turn it actually up. The lighting on it. Not that it needs it. I was just thinking. Oh, actually, how do you do that? And there's definitely a way because I've done it before, but I forgot. Oh well, I never mind. There's loads of little things on this Phoenix that I keep finding, like new things I keep going, oh, that's, I haven't seen that before, that's cool. See, like, I mean, look at that there, that's like, so that's for your, I guess it was where the old, where I used to put your charts and things like that, notepad and stuff. That's cool. Pleases me. Should we get down to then? Should we get down to, let's just level off at one, fly 100, sorry. Because why the hell not? Very low as well. I'm gonna just check actually what stand the real flight went on to earlier. So we're Ryanair 32 Charlie Victor FR212. It's usually 737, but we don't care. Oh, they've sent it right around the back. Oh, actually, they sent it on the new taxiway up the north of the airfield. He went on to stand 109 right. So we're gonna go on 109 right. Because I want to see on the MK Studios Dublin what actually is modelled in terms of the new runway, if it is at all. It may not be, in fairness. Ooh. Right then, here comes top of drop. Well, we've got like a 70 knot wind to on the crosswind here. Can definitely hear someone transmitting on Unicorn. I don't know if it's just me going berserk, but I'm pretty sure I can hear someone transmitting. I want to see the transmit button, but obviously they're not going to do it while I'm looking at it, are they? As soon as I close this damn watch, I'll bet I'll hear it. Yep, I actually did hear it. Oh. Company message, or you're delayed again. 10 minutes delay. Oh, tough. On the flight plan page. Cool. descending. Let's get the announcement out there. Take your goddamn seats. Now, do we do the full arrival, or do we do a sneaky direct, seeing as there's no ATC on? What do we do? I think we do a direct. I need to save that, I think, as a beacon cam. It looks pretty cool. Oh! Oh, shit. More traffic. This, I had this earlier. I think we're going to crash. Oh, he's climbing. Can't believe that. Oh, my God. That's twice in the same day we've had that. It's an easy bus. Twat, I can't believe that. I've literally not had one of those in yonks. And I've had two in the same day. That's shocking. Where can we do a direct from then? So if we go from... Let's go Rimvu Pizza. Rimvu to Pizza. I think that'll do. Rimvu Pizza. So what do we want to do? We want to delete Bagso. We want to delete Adsis. We want to delete Kerav. We want to delete Kogax, and we want to delete the Discon, and then insert, and that should, there you go, beautiful. This actually puts on a better profile there as well, approach profile. Can't believe I've just had another near crash. That's just unreal. So we need to be at 3,000 feet at Pizza. Use a bit of the break of shame. Now it should be FS realistic, unless I just haven't set it up properly. When you put the speed brake out, there you go, that's more like it. That's more like it. Literally rumbles the plane. There's another aircraft to the... Oh, he's well above us, that's fine. God, I was just going to think... I was going to log off then. What's going on? Okay, so you can be armed. Keep an eye on this guy in front of me. Oh, London's just come on. but we're just coming out of his airspace anyway, so well, I can't actually see the aircraft coming into Dublin on the TCAS yet, so he's obviously a bit further below us. Flap free. Do one. You can go and do one with your flap free landing. That's not happening again. You made me look like a right mug earlier. Oh dear. You're going to laugh, I'm going to cry. Do you know what though, that one earlier, even though it was so bad, it was only like 211 feet per minute. So it just shows you can't judge it by that number, can you? Because it was a lot worse than that. I was just thinking what I need to do as well. The picture I've got behind my webcam now, so the cockpit obviously, I need to do one where I've turned the lights down on it as well, so it's really dark. So like when it's night time or when we're on the approach and things like that, I can switch to that one. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, it's based on G's. Yeah, not. And the thing is, especially with the Boeing more so with the 737, they're actually taught to firmly land the aircraft. You know, it actually says in the actual SOP of the aircraft, the ACOM, that's right, FCOM, sorry, to actually plant the bloody thing down. So yeah, be firm, basically. It also says about the nose wheel as well. Make sure that's a firm, you know, whacking it down. Dublin traffic, 103.2 Charlie Victor, just at Flover 140, descending 3,000 feet, expecting ILS 28 left to a corner, established 28 left, currently on the Bags 03 X-ray arrival. Dublin traffic. Yeah, that's one of the worst I've done earlier. That was. Do you know what that what threw me with it though? When the main gear touched out, we had a warning come up. There was some sort of main caution come up, master caution. And then I was thinking, what the hell is that like? I was like, oh, what's going on? And then all of a sudden, the back wheels hit again. So I didn't even realise we'd actually took off again. To be fair, because I would have probably gone around at that point, but I didn't even know. So there was me thinking, that was, you know, a bit odd, but, and then all of a sudden it bounces back down again. I'm thinking, geez, that's what I mean. That's a proper Backbreaker Express, that is, mate. I'm telling you. Why can't I see this guy in front? Was, well, that would make sense, you know, yeah, that would make sense. I thought it said something like, yeah, it could well have been, to be honest. I didn't think about that. I thought it was the fact that I hadn't retarded the throttles properly, but yeah, it probably was the fact I'd engage reverse while we were in the we were still flying. But as I say, it's the first config free I've done for yonks, so I'm blaming you fully for that. So yeah, definitely weren't my poor piloting skills. Right then, there's flight of 100. Look at that sunset just reflecting off that. Wow. That's, tell you what, you've hit the nail there, you know. But then I'm thinking, well, you know what, the PMDG 800's coming out soon, so I'm thinking, is there any point? Because I'm just going to be on that, like, all the time, until it's, like, literally until I wear the blooming thing out. So it's either going to break me first or my PC, so you know, we've got a fight coming up there. So I'm thinking, it's probably no point, to be honest. Let's just put LS on here. There we go. So yeah, I've just really got into this aircraft, and now I'm going to be heading off to the PMGZ when that comes in, but I'll probably do a bit of both, to be honest. But I also need to start doing some of the fly-by-wire Neo, because that's a fantastic aircraft as well. That's a real awesome aircraft. I'm just worried I can't see this aircraft in front, and he's not far in front. Looking at VATSCOPE, he's not far in front at all. Actually, he's on the approach now, so I should I'd expect to see him at sort of LATMO. There he is. There he is. Dublin traffic, runway 32 Charlie Victor, inbound pizza, and then LATMO expecting RS 28 left. We'll call when it's obvious 28 left. Dublin traffic. Pizza. What's the funny shape? Oh, is that, that's the missed approach, isn't it? I think it brings you back round downwind. That's changed though, that wasn't, it didn't used to look like that, the missed approach. So that's quite cool that they've changed that. There is another aircraft off coming in as well. It looks about the same level as me coming in, so I might have to do a bit of deviating a little bit. You have to keep an eye on the TCAS there. Oh, fly by wire, sorry, yeah. Yeah, I know what you mean. I know exactly what you mean with that. And you're right, it does. But then I'm thinking, is that right? And is it a slightly different shape? You're talking about this bit, aren't you? Like this bit here. The shape of that, if I'm thinking right. I know what you mean, though. Yeah, I know exactly what you mean. You're right, it is. It's something you do get used to a little bit, though. It is angled down. Yeah. Now, I don't know if that's true to life, and this is not 100%, or whether, yeah, it needs. But that's a Sobo, isn't it, I suppose? That's a Sobo's modelling issue, I suppose. We need to activate the approach phase, don't we? Otherwise, we're going to get bad speeds. You can see it on the pictures. It's not... Yeah. I've not really looked in detail at it, to be honest, comparing it to, like, the real aircraft, but... No, I know exactly what you mean. I have thought that before. That's how I knew exactly what you meant when I took you to the... there. Yeah. And I'm wondering whether that is something they'd even be able to change, to be honest with you, because it's, as I say, that's a Sobo, isn't it? And I don't know whether they can actually change the model of it that much, or I don't know. Where's this other aircraft then? Is it going to be one of these again, where he, like, just jumps in front of me? Look at that for the profile, that's brought me bang on where we need to be for where we are. How cool is that? Right, we're going to drop flaps one now. And we're going to drop that to about 190. How about the FSX? Oh yeah, that was terrible, wasn't it? That was so bad. But you know what, at the time, everyone was like, oh, this is awesome, because if it's what you've... It's kind of what you know, isn't it? And it's kind of what you get used to. Like, say now, for example, if you said to me, can you fly the Aerosoft Airbus? I wouldn't be able to. The Aerosoft Extended Airbus. Like, that was really old now. I don't think I'd be able to. Because you get used to what you're currently using, don't you? This has spoiled us. Like, this type of aircraft spoils us, because you just get... Quality wings was good. Yeah. I did loads of good flying in that. I used to love that. Okay, flaps 2, we're going to drop to 160 knots then now. I used to love the quality wing 757, it was brilliant.
Traffic,
and Dublin traffic, runway 32 Charlie Victor, just about to turn onto the ILS runway 28 left, Dublin traffic. Yeah, Quality Wings was fantastic aircraft. In fact, the did you fly the 787 on P3D? That was another fantastic aircraft, actually. I used to love that. Oh, I've still got the tray tables here. I've still got my feet up. Still having a relax. It's time to do a bit of work, I think. How's that captured? Cool, we have captured the eyeless. Did you fly the... Oh, the Quality Wing 787. No, that was an awesome aircraft as well. Oh, wow, look at that. Look at all the lighting coming in. Do you know, I don't really fly often at this time of night, but it's absolutely stunning in this sim. When you look at that lighting that's reflecting off those clouds, the red sky. That's just so cool. Dublin traffic, runway 32 Charlie Victor, currently at 8 mile final, runway 28 left Dublin traffic. Fly factor 787, yeah, that is going to be mint. I can't wait for a long haul aircraft, to be honest, for this sim. It's just going to be brilliant. Let's go manual, we're a bit far out, I like flying this manually. What harm can we do, let's face it, after the earlier catastrophe we had? Yeah, we definitely needing a good long-haul aircraft for this sim, 100%. Are you flying this sim then now, or are you still on sort of X-Plane P3D, or...? You said you flew the fly-by-wire, didn't you? So you're obviously on this then. And 60, okay, so we're going to slow to 150. And at 5 miles, which is another mile to go, we'll drop the gear. I mean, look at that. Wow. It takes your breath sometimes, the level of detail on this sim. Look at that for a wing view. Okay, gear down. Flaps 4. Ignoring Jamie to go flaps 3. And if I plant this down, I'm still blaming you. See, you can even see the landing light illuminating the actual, you know, bit in front of the aircraft. You probably can't see it very well on the stream. Let me turn them off, see if that... There you go, it's the taxi lights. And I'm not looking at the runway at all, so it's not very professional of me. But you can see, yeah, it does. There's an aircraft just departed, so that's okay. That is just so immersive. So we should be at the VLS speed now. That's the caution. I don't know why it's giving me that, because my... Do you know what? Let's just go auto throttle off, sod it. I was in the click spot, so I don't know why I was doing that. Okay, gears down, auto brakes low, speed brakes are armed. We can disregard the auto throttle because we've got manual control of it. None of this was in. No, you're right. That's for me. That's what these aircraft have brought to the sim. All right, so the runway looks clear.
Above. Minimum.
Continuing.
100. 50. 40. 30. 20. Retard. 5.
That's better. That's better. Told you it was flaps. It was flaps free. Config free. That's what did it. Manual brakes. Welcome to Dublin, mate. Welcome to Dublin. Have we got a landed? Yeah, I've got a landed thing, I think. There we go. Not sure it does anything on that. I haven't programmed it to do anything, but... Awesome. So that was nice. I enjoyed that. That was a nice... That approach was beautiful with that sunset. Well, it's just in my timer for 3 minutes. Timer started. That can come off. Landing lights can come off. You can go to taxi. You can go to off. And that's it for now. We'll start the APU in a bit. Dublin traffic, Ryanair 3-2, Charlie Victor, runway 2LFD is vacated. We're going to taxi on Alpha up to the gate. Landing system can come off. I can't wait for the A2. Yeah, that's just, you just know that's going to happen, didn't you? Well, if that's the case, I'm never going to fly the Airbus again then. If they mandate config free. We're all just making an excuse on every landing to say, no, sorry, I have to use full. Because that just shows you the difference, doesn't it? That, you know, that was a decent landing. It would help if I get some charts up on it, because I couldn't say the taxi because I didn't know it. And I didn't want to bullshit. There's about a million charts, so you just have to guess which one is. That's the one. The airport. Oh, look, see, they've put it on. It's actually on the charts now as well with the new runway. Ah, that's so cool. So that's 3,109 metres. And the old. Oh, it's actually longer than 28 left. I didn't know that. So we're going to go up. We're going to go Whiskey 2, Mike 1, and then we're going to go up to see how far up we can go up to the north. North of the airport. Yeah, that's it. That's what did throw me off, and plus the wind as well. Not making excuses, it was a crap landing, but the wind really put me off, so I was like struggling before I even started the approach, to be honest.
Oh yeah.
Shut the flight directors off now. Get this APU started as well. Thanks for the follow. My apologies, the thing's gone off my screen, so I can't even see who it was. But thank you so much, whoever it was. I really need to set this up like properly and get all the alerts and stuff like that so I can see them. I can hear it, but I couldn't see it on the screen then. I'll have to have a look, but thank you anyway. Okay, APU starting. Okay, yeah, that is starting. Okay. Dublin traffic running 3 to Charlie Victor, just about to cross 1634 Dublin traffic. Oh, Jack. Thanks, mate. Appreciate that. Yeah, I need to set the stream up properly. It's just a bit crap at the moment. As you can probably see with the webcam and all of the colours, etc., it's just. I look like I'm sweating constantly, which I generally am, to be fair, because my room's like full of radiation. It's that hot, but yeah, I need to sort it all out. I need to see all the sort of alerts and things like that. Yeah, thanks for following them. I hope you're well. I think that's such a cool view in your taxi. There's an aircraft up there, actually. Ha! Is he using the new runway? Is he using the northerly runway? Fair play for years. Now, I need to work out whether... So I can turn right... I can either turn right here, but where does it take me up there? I need to put the parking brake on a sec because I need to have a look at how far up I can go. See, if I go up there, I'm actually going to be on the runway there. So, okay. Okay, that makes sense. So what I'm going to do is just carry on, turn right here. Is it... I don't think it is yet. No, it's not. I actually sent a message to MK Studios and said, have you got any plans on bringing it in? It would have been nice, and in hindsight, and, you know, they're obviously busy people, if they could have kind of put a patch or a fix out in time for the runway opening. I think that would have just been awesome. But I guess the challenge is, it's whether online services like VATSIM will actually let you land and depart on that runway, because a lot of people ain't, some people are not going to have it, some people are, so they're not going to be able to say, you know, give you clearances from that runway, are they, in case you can't take it, I suppose. I don't really know how it works, to be fair. But yeah, I wouldn't imagine it's going to be long before developers jump on it. Oh, what stands do we got? Do we got here? One, crikey, I can't even see them. 109. Yeah, that's what we wanted, wasn't it? 109 right. 109 right, which is just this one here by the looks of it. Oh, I don't know why my brakes aren't working. There you are. I must have nailed the brakes on that landing. Turn the lights off so we don't blind them. This is the right hand one. Cool. I can't see happening. Yeah. True. Yeah, I mean, I guess that's right. Yeah, if you... Oh, Jesus. If you do... you're right. If you've got it and you ask for it, then surely they can't stop you, you know. If they're using it in real life especially. This is terrible parking. I must say, this is like pretty much as bad as my wife's parking. And I hope to God she's not watching. This is pretty bad. Okay, parking brake set. We're at okay, we're over 3 minutes, so we can switch those off. Beacon come off. Dome can come on. Let's get some light in here. Okay, Jamie, co-pilot Jamie. Thanks for that. Thanks for doing nothing. Making me want to do a config free. You can head off back into the cabin now, Jamie, if you like. I'll just open the door, so watch the camera. There you go. I mean, come on. Come on, that is just... that is just a game changer, isn't it? Told you simple things, you know, please me. See, look at that, minus 143. I'm taking that all the way to the bank. That's a winner. We'll take credit for the landing, yeah. Please, yeah, yeah. I think you should take credit for the previous landing in Stansted earlier. I'm having credit for that one. That was a decent landing, actually. I mean, yeah, the parking's actually turned out not too bad, to be honest. I've done worse, that's for sure. Am I going to do a return? I'm not sure, you know. I'm not sure. You've got a reputation for hard landings on 2-2. Okay. I won't ask then. What I'm doing, I need to get some... there's no jetways here, is there? Well, they don't use them anyway, I guess, but... Baggage. We'll get the stairs in, shall we? I am going to get GSX at some point, but... Actually, I wonder whether... That's a good point. I wonder whether the cabin lights come on when I switch them on in the tab. I don't actually know the answer to this. Oh, wow, that's pretty cool. Wow, that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. Yeah, that's nice. That was a lot. Yeah, and the actual cockpit lights... Oh, actually, Jamie, you are... Uh-huh. By the looks of it. And that's me. Got me all handsome with me shades on. Ooh. So yeah, I'm going to get a picture of obviously what it is now. You can see with all the lights on. You have biffies. Well, now you know. I wanted to see what it looks like with all the lights turned off in here, so it's really dark. But I'm not sure how dark you can actually get it in here. You have to turn off all the lights, I guess, wouldn't you? I don't know if any of these are going to make any difference at all. I don't think they are. I think that's probably as dark as you're going to get it looking back that way. But I guess what doesn't help is you've got the airport lighting, haven't you? So I'm going to have to go somewhere where there's no airport lighting and get that reverse picture. Yeah, that's it, because it all reflects, doesn't it? So I'm going to have to get the displays all turned down. Oh, wow, look at that. See, that's something I've never noticed before. There's actually like a mirror there looking back at that. I never even saw that before. What do you think that's for? Do you think that's for Jamie to stand up and do his hair in, you know, in mid-flight? Just, do you know what I mean? Just have a check on the throw, on the do, like. You know what I mean? I don't know. Could be right. Let's get these windows open and get some air in. Yeah, if you're any doubt to in this aircraft, it's phenomenal. Absolutely phenomenal. To make sure you look fabulous. Yeah, I'm sure you always look fabulous, mate, but yeah. Fair enough. I think I'm gonna call that a night because I'm literally just melting. I'm so hot in this room, it's unbelievable. So I will call it a night, but thanks for watching and thanks for following. If you're mirrors for the yeah, that's it, innit? That's it. It's all for the selfies. You've probably got a point there, in fairness. It probably is, because there is a hell of a lot on there, isn't there, that do that sort of stuff. I'm not sure I'd do it. I'd just do it of like the wing view, or you know, the simple things like in flight sim that you get. But I just, yeah, I mean, how cool is that? This cabin is so cool. I've actually got one for the EasyJet livery as well, and that's properly like modelled EasyJet. Absolutely awesome. I'm going to have a quick look while I'm here just to see what actually is modelled in this scene. So I'm just going to pop it to lighter weather. I'm just going to disconnect from that scene. I want to see how much of actually the new runway is modelled, because I think they did model some of it. Let me just speed the camera up a bit. Yeah, so they have modelled a little bit of it, look. So they've started the taxiways here. So if I'm writing... Oh, no, they haven't. No, because the runway is this heading, isn't it? That's the runway here. So this is taken from Bing, then, this is. So that must mean that was when they were doing it, because there's only two high-speed exits, so that's right, yeah. So that there is the actual scenery from MK Studios. It kind of ends here. And then the rest of it's Bing, isn't it? So that's... But I didn't know that the new runway is actually going to be longer than... 2-8 left, 10 right. I didn't know that. But hopefully there'll be a patch, an update from them to get it in use, because that'd be really cool. I mean, especially when the PMDG 738 comes out, because let's face it, Ryanair is just going to get nailed, isn't it? Once that comes out, everyone and his dog are going to be flying Ryanair, including myself. Like, there's no doubt about that. So, yeah. It's going to be just completely nailed with Ryanair aircraft. This airport's just going to be full of Ryanair, isn't it? So it would be nice if they could do it for that, but yeah. Maybe they will. I don't know. I have messaged them, and so, you know, you'll be flying Ryanair. Do you fly on Microsoft Flight Sim then, Jack, as well? I was actually going to put in my Discord link in the chat to see. So I haven't even set it up. I'm gonna try and put it in the thing so you can come in. Moisture Flight Sim, yeah, cool. I'm gonna see if I can put the Discord link in the chat so you can feel free to jump in there. And perhaps we could fly together at some point. I think this is the server one. Server invite, I'm 100% sure. Bit of a noob to all this stuff, I must admit. Bit of a noob. Hopefully, that'll take you into my Discord. Hopefully. There you are, Jack. Ah, that's worked then, that's good. I need to pin that. Awesome, mate. Yeah, be nice to have be nice to do a group flight or something at some point. And I'll tell you what, I can't wait for the ability to do shared cockpit in Microsoft Flight Sim. That is gonna be so cool. Hi Jamie. Hi mate. Yeah, when you can do that, when you can do shared cockpit, that's just gonna be absolutely immense. But yeah, if you let us know when you're planning to fly next, guys, we'll jump on and do something together. That'd be pretty cool, wouldn't it? So anyway, I'm gonna shoot off anyway. But yeah, nice flying, and thanks for joining, Jack. Thanks for following, appreciate it. You can do it. Oh, okay, Jack. Okay. I didn't know that. I didn't know you could do it in the fly-by-wire. Did you ever try? I don't know if you were on X-Plane, Jamie. Did you ever try shared cockpit? Because that was good on X-Plane. I've used that a couple of times actually on X-Plane, and it's really good. It's really quite accurate. Things like synced really well. I didn't know they did that with the fly-by-wire, so I might have to look into that. And is that on the latest sort of version, is it, or is it on the stable version? Because I think I'm on the experimental one, I think. So I'm not sure which model you need for that. But yeah, either way, that would be quite cool to try it out, wouldn't it? No, there's no harm in trying it. Oh, okay, sound. So you sent it on Discord. Nice one. Right then, guys. Awesome. Thanks for watching. Thanks for following as well. Really appreciate it. And I'll hopefully stream tomorrow evening, maybe, if I'm about. So yeah, it'd be really good to see you guys there. So I'm off anyway. Take care. I'll catch you soon.